The United States and Europe are fully united. Today, I'm announcing that the United States will be sending 31 Abrams tanks to Ukraine.
M1 Abrams is widely regarded as the single best main battle tank in the world today. And it has performed in combat against Soviet and Russian-made tanks very effectively. Getting those vehicles will improve their ability to take ground. But I would be a little cautious about assuming that with them, they will conquer the world. Without them, they're hopeless, right? It's not as decisive as that. Yeah, certainly Ukraine needs all of the heavy armor it can get. The number of tanks the U.S. is committed to sending isn't large enough to make a huge difference on the battlefield. In all likelihood, this was the price of getting the Germans to agree to send much larger numbers of a comparably effective vehicle, the Leopard 2. So this is probably as much politics as battlefield combat effectiveness.
If you look at the past year of the war, at every step there's been reluctance to supply, you know, more advanced weaponry to Ukraine because of the fear of Russian escalation, of the Russian reaction, and the concern, at least in, particularly in the United States, that the US cannot get directly involved in a conflict with Russia because that's too dangerous. And yet, slowly but surely, all of these constraints have vanished. And so now we are, you know, the Ukrainians will get these top of the line tanks from the United States, from Germany. The fact that the Germans were finally willing to supply the Ukrainians with these tanks really does show that this is a sea change in the way that Germany views its relationship with Russia and with Russia's neighbors, and also, I would say, with Central and Eastern Europe.
Чим більше оборонної підтримки наші герої на фронті отримують від світу, тим швидше закінчиться агресія Росії, і тим надійніше будуть гарантії безпеки для України усіх наших партнерів після війни. Держава-терорист повинна програти. Право на життя людей має бути захищене, і так і буде.
Clearly what we're going to see happening is threats from the Russians that if you do this, then we will have to respond. But it's not clear exactly what they will do. In an ideal scenario, it could bring the war closer to an end if the Ukrainians make enough progress that the Russians realize that they're not going to achieve the aims that they want to achieve now, which is the recognition by Ukraine of the annexation of these four territories.